always gotta get the boss. It looks weird. I just gotta adjust the fender closer.
Yeah.
It actually helps.
What is up, guys? Welcome back to the videos. In today's video, we're gonna be working on the Z, and this is something that's been long overdue. I've been pushing it on the back burner for like the longest time. The Z has been making a really bad rattling sound, and it's been going on since. It's been going on since probably winter time, and I probably should have fixed this sooner. I thought it was just like a bushing, which I ended up changing. That didn't fix the issue. I thought it was a stabilizer link, but that didn't fix the issue either. I'll try to get the car to do it. Like that. I don't know if you can hear that. But it's like a really loose suspension sound. I don't know if the camera's picking that up, but it's really like, it sounds loose. My dad and his mechanics friends started saying that it could be a strut mount because it does sound like that. I don't know, I don't think it's the strut mount. My dad and I were driving, he told me to hold the brakes while going down a bumpy road a little bit just to kind of lock up the front calipers a bit, and the sound went away. So that tells my dad it's definitely the brakes. We're gonna be checking the slide pins and changing the whole caliper. So let's go ahead and work on the Z. So this is the caliper here. This is the part that has a little bit of play. It's not even that much. This is what we suspect is causing all the noise, and it's getting super, super loud, which is crazy because it doesn't look like a whole lot, but when the car is like driving and it goes over bumps, it actually makes a really loud sound. So I was just about to throw this on, and I noticed the play on, this is the new caliper like cradle. And we noticed that the play on the new one is even more than the one that we're replacing. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna return this, because honestly, sometimes buying from like Piston Ring or Napa or whatever is the same as eBay. You don't really know the quality so much. So we're gonna be returning those. And my dad is just repacking the grease in the cradle over there. And we're gonna see if that helps quiet down the issue. So we just finished this side here. We repacked the slide pins with more grease and stuff. I have this side's wheel out. So I'm working on the passenger side brake, and my dad just went ahead and put more grease, and there is a lot less play. So we tried putting on this one, since this one actually had like less play. We got this from the junkyard, and this one actually didn't fit. This, if we put this on, this would cause the brake pad to go over the rotor, so obviously that's not what I want. And we didn't want to use the new one because the new one actually has more play than the ones we already have. So we went ahead and repacked them. Hopefully this will quiet it down. Like I said, we'll go ahead and take this car for a test drive once I have this all back together. We just finished installing the brake calipers. We're gonna drive down my street because it's a little bumpy, and hopefully we're good. Stepping on the brake while the car is moving, it doesn't do it.
Let go.
It happens as soon as I let go.
What the hell is that, man?
I have no idea. I don't know, like I torqued everything. Everything should be tight and good, and it still makes the same freaking sound. I don't know what the hell it could be. I don't think it's the spacer, because the spacer was, we torqued the spacer on and it's really tight. The rotor doesn't even move when the wheel's off. Like, I don't know, could it be, we checked all like the bushings on the upper control arm too, the ball joints. Literally everything when it was up on a hoist, and we even tried it on the four post hoist. So the suspension is under load. Literally, it still makes the same sound. We tried prying on everything. checking out the bushings. We changed the sway bar bushings too, lower control arm bushings, stabilizer link. I don't know what the hell this could be. And the weirdest thing, it doesn't do it when I'm drifting. It's only literally on this street here when it's like kind of bumpy. But over big bumps, it doesn't do it. So I don't know what the heck is wrong with this car.
My dad put the car up on jack stands, the front end, and he started shaking it down. And he noticed that when the car was parked, when he would shake the wheel kind of like this, there would be like a kind of like a knocking sound. That knocking sound you just heard was my seatbelt. I don't have any phone. That's when he tightened up something on the rack. I think it was like the pinion gear or something like that. And I'll go down here in the street and just test it. It's still there. No, it's still there.
So right now we are at Innova. There it is. I have the Z here, and we're gonna be putting it up the hoist to double check everything with the rack and pinion. Worst case scenario, I know it is really hard to find a right-hand drive rack and pinion, especially for like a newer import like this, so there's not a lot of part outs, but my dad said worst case scenario, we can take apart the rack, maybe not today, but we can take the rack off and get it rebuilt, and hopefully that would fix the issue, because that's what he thinks it is. He thinks it's the worm gear, and there's a bushing that holds the worm gear. If that makes sense, if you guys know what I'm talking about, cool. Yeah, he thinks it's the rack and pinion, so we just want to put it up the hoist just to make sure that that is the actual issue. All right, so we have found what we think is the culprit to the sound, which is the compression rod right here. So when my dad pried this down from here, you can kind of feel it. Actually, it's actually worse on this one. It looks okay, like the boot isn't ripped at all. But when my dad would pry down here from the caliper, and you can feel like there is a play here, and it makes a slight clunking sound when we pry it down, which would make sense because when we're driving it, it makes a really loud clunking sound. We think this is the issue. The thing is, this isn't serviceable. So if I want to change this piece right here, I would have to change the whole freaking arm. So I'm gonna look online to see how much that is. I'd probably want to get like a Nissan one. I don't know if they sell aftermarket ones of these, but this is what we have to change. And I did order rack spacers, which would delete this bump stop, so at least everything within what I'm doing would be new. So that's good. I'm glad we finally found the issue, because this issue has been on the car since probably, I want to say winter time, so over 3 months for sure. So I'm glad that we found the issue. Now I just have to change it, probably when I order the part in another video.
We just finished working. Oh, so hard to drive with one hand. All right, so we just finished working on the Z. Now we're headed to a car meet. It's not really a car meet. It's more like a spot that everyone just hangs out. I've put this in my video a couple of times before. Right now we're with my brother, Josh, and our friend, Ken. Josh is gonna be taking some pictures of the cars and stuff like that. And I don't know, I'm just gonna be hanging out. Hopefully there's some nice cars that I can show you guys and put in the video.
All right, so me and the guys made it to Northgate. Ken's car is over there, Josh's, mine. This is my friend Jaden's EK. It's fucking sick, it's so cool. Usually I'm not like a huge fan of like Hondas, but this thing is super clean. Got the spoon stickers too, carbon hood. Damn, this thing looks so cool. It's all set up for the track too. Oh shit. That's sick.
There you go.
So wait, is this, does this, is that like, yo, that's sick. That's so cool. Is it under the hood too?
Under the hood. Everywhere.
Dude, you're giving me ideas for Ariana. Jeez, or the Evo. This is so cool. But what kind of like paint is that?
That's the black pearl.
Black pearl?
Yeah,
damn, black it looks pearl. Like rainbow.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's so cool. Josh. Take a look at this.
Look, it's everywhere.
Look at that.
It's everywhere.
This is, I know, right? It's so sick. Look, even under the hood. Dude, look at that.
Nice touch.
And you did this just at home? That's crazy. That's so cool. It looks so professional too. Filipino style, yeah. The wide boy is back. Look how fucking wide the Z is. Why'd he leave me? Yo, the chaser. Yeah. Do it, sure. That's sick. He did it for the vlog. Yay! All right, so right now we're going with Jaden, the guy with the EG, my brother, and Ken to like a photo shoot spot and just kind of hang out. So hopefully we can get some pretty cool shots of all the cars together, because I think the cars would look really cool together. So let's go ahead and check it out. Damn, we made it to the spot. This is just like a gas station. This is actually like for semis, but all the cars look sick here. Damn. Hopefully no semis come here to like fill up. We got the white STI, Josh's Evo, the yellow Z, and the EG looking OG. Fuck, this car is so clean. Damn. Damn, look at that. The gauges and everything. Oh, we're gonna go to the other side. But the bride seats.
You can hop in just a little bit back.
Like these bride seats actually like match like the year and era of the car. Such a well-built car. It looks so cool. Yeah. Can't get over this. Making me wanna build a Honda. Josh is really into the EG too. How stiff the car is. Holy.
Isn't the Paul Walker like... Is it safe to sit down?
Is it safe to sit? It looks so awkward. He's like, I don't want to...
Like, where he's like, cuffed in.
Yeah.
Then cross your legs, yo.
What the fuck was that? Yeah, so just look at us. Yeah, there you go. Yeah. Boogie. Yeah. What do you think?
10% stuff.
10%.
All right, boys, we're in business. Yeah, dude, I feel like it was better when I was on 10%.
Airplane, get the airplane. It's right here. Where is it? Oh! Holy, it's so low! Holy shit.
On your next video, okay guys, I lost my thing.
I lost my camera, I left it here.
We don't have any videos today.
This engine bay looks so clean. It's like a better look at it under the light, but... All of that. All done at home. That's crazy.
Alright, so we just finished like hanging out. This was my first time seeing Jaden's EG, and it is so clean, and it's amazing to think that he pulled the engine, he painted the engine bay. Literally everything that's done to that car was done at home at his house. And it just shows to prove that if you have the right motivation and if you want to actually build a car, you don't need a whole shop. You can do it at your house. It's so crazy. The thing is so clean. He races it, he tracks the car, and it's clean. It looks like it could be like a show car or something like that. To me, it was really inspiring to see what you can do, even how limited your resources could be. It's so crazy just to think what you can actually build at home. Anyways, it's getting really late. I have to edit this video. I'm gonna have to end the video here. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, remember to leave a like, subscribe, and join the Anti-Perfect Society. Peace out, and make it happen.